So what is spanning tree? The spanning tree is a subset of raw mode. Okay, spanning tree is a discrete mathematics. So this is topic in, which is in discrete mathematics. We will use the spanning tree for the calculations and algorithms. These algorithms we use to calculate the shortest path. So the suppose means end lines. So next networks. So this is useful in networks and airlines, and which suppose if you want to reach the short way, suppose from your college to home, if I want to find the road means shortest path. Means if I want to find means we will use this spanning tree. So okay, so here the spanning tree is a subset of graph G and which has all the vertices covered with minimum possible number of edges. Which is it? Actually this is a subset of graph G. Whatever graph suppose, graph G. This is a graph G. Okay, so this is a graph G. So this is a subset of, in this we are finding the subset of spanning tree. Okay, if you consider graph, this is a graph, by this you will find the spanning tree. What is spanning tree? Spanning tree is a subset of graph G or graph G. And here what is the graph? Is a subset of, what is the graph? Graph is a subset of points or nodes. And see here, so what is this spanning tree first? So this is vertices which are interconnected by a set of lines called edges. First we have to know the about what is the edge and what is the vertices. Right? So first what is the graph? Is a set of points. So we know this is the spanning tree, the subset of graph. Before going to the spanning tree, first we have to learn that what is the spanning tree, what is the graph G. What is the graph first? Graph is a set of points. Set of points means these all are points. Set of points called the nodes. These all are nodes. And what are the interconnected from A to B and B to C and C to A to C? These all interconnected lines are called edges. See, these are the these points are vertices and the interconnected lines are called edges. Okay, so this is the spanning tree. And spanning tree, one more special point we have here. Spanning tree does not have, this is very clear point you have to know. The spanning tree does not have a cycle. Does not have a cycle and it cannot be a disconnected. So this is very important, spanning tree. So already you know this is a subset of graph G. Okay, already know the graph. What is the graph? What is the vertices? What is the edges? And here the spanning tree, what is the specialty of spanning tree in the graph? Spanning tree is a tree which does not have the cycle, means does not have the complete cycle. Okay, and it does not be a disconnected. So right, now suppose this is a graph, we are from this graph we are connecting the spanning tree. Spanning tree specialty means what? What is the spanning tree? Spanning tree does not have the cycle. Means does not have the cycle, means we have to find the means we have to find this from this graph, you have to find the spanning tree. Means here see, does not have the cycle, we have no cycle. So from this here also no cycle, means these many ways we have to find the spanning tree. So from this graph we are finding because of this three all the subset of graph G. Okay, so here I am seeing these many, first way A and A to B, A to C. So these are the what vertices I am connecting in the interconnected lines of edges. See here, so I am not following the cycle. So this is called the spanning tree. Spanning tree. Okay, and see, and another way, suppose if you consider first way and the second way and third way, means third way. Three ways I am finding from G. Okay, here the first A. A means here, this is one way, and the second way, A to C and C to B, because of here no cycle. So here also this is the one way of finding the spanning tree. And this is also, see from graph G only I am taking this all the three ways. Okay, see here what is this A, B and C, here also not connected. Means these are two are same I think, and if you want to find this, you can otherwise. So this is the way. See, because of little bit changes for this A to B and B to C, because of this is also no cycle, so this is also connected, means no cycle, here no cycle, and here also no cycle, and here also no cycle. So from the graph only, first we have to draw the graph G, means graph diagram, and then we have to find the spanning tree from that graph. Okay, so and weight, how to find the weight of spanning tree? Because of I have to find that weight, but how much? Because of suppose if you consider this is a way and this is a way. Suppose here is a college, from here to your room you are going. So what is the weight of this way? That means how much cost of this way we are finding. See, the weight of spanning tree is the sum of weights of all the edges in the tree. Edges means what? These are the interconnected lines, is called the edges. These are all our vertices. So here, what is this? The weight of spanning tree. Weight of spanning tree is the sum of weights of all the edges in the tree. Edges means these all are the interconnected lines or edges. So I have to find these edges. See here, I have given the same example. Suppose if I take this spanning tree diagram. See, I am giving this one. So this is your option. If you want to give more than 1, 2, 3 like this, also you have to give this. And here I am giving 1 and 2. A to B interconnected line is 1. I am giving this weight. And here A to C, here I am giving 2. Okay. So here I am giving 2. Right. So what is the weight of all the edges in the tree? Means 1 plus A to B and A to C. 1 plus 2. This is the 3 is the weight of spanning tree. Right, this is the weight of spanning tree, and this minimum spanning tree. This is the process. How to find the means weight of spanning tree. This is the one step. Means this is one step, and second step minimum, because of in the weight also minimum we will consider. So minimum spanning tree. More MST, minimum spanning tree. This is a full form of shortcut way of giving. So if this is a spanning tree with the smallest weight, suppose I am giving here, if I have a diagram, okay, 1 and 2. See here, so one more diagram I will explain here. See, this is what? This is a graph. Okay, I have to find first is from this graph, I have to draw the spanning tree. Okay, from this graph, I have to draw the diagram of spanning tree without cycle. So without cycle, first I have to form from this another diagram, means spanning tree. Then I have to minimum spanning tree, means smallest weight I have to find. What is the smallest weight? Because of this is a diagram. Right, so here what is this one? A to C, A to B, first A to B. So A to B, 2, the weight is 2. And next A to C is 3, here 3. And here C to D means what? What is it? 1, when I am giving the weight. And see, so because of, if I draw a line from here to here, it will be a cycle. This is not a spanning tree. So right, because of the condition what I am giving in the first line, this is if you want to find a spanning tree, it doesn't have the cycling. Right? So that's why I am not giving this line and this line. If I find this line, this is also cycling. This is not a spanning tree. So I am stopping from this here. What is this? So I am giving the 1, 3 and 2. So right? So if I give a line 5 also, it is not a spanning tree. So because of no cycles, no interconnected lines, right? So here this is the spanning tree. I mean, suppose if you want to another way also, so many ways we have to draw the diagram like that graph. And see here, minimum weight means, because of why I am taking like this, means because of minimum spanning tree. Minimum spanning tree cost means the smallest cost for that. And because of if you want to take minimum means most of the time means highest cost, means you have to find this like this way. Because of 6 plus 2 plus like the otherwise from here to here you can connect, no problem. From here to here 6 plus 2 means 8 will come. This is the highest weight will come. Because of the question what I am asking means minimum weight means smallest weight I want. smallest weight is 6. This is the smallest weight. Suppose minimum spanning tree used in the design of network. So what is the use? Suppose if we are doing a if any work, while we are doing that work, it is some purpose we will do. Okay, this is also, so the spanning tree also, why we are developing the spanning tree means we have to find the smallest path, means airlines, networks, while we are going from here to there, you know, means shortcut ways we will use. So this is the minimum spanning tree used in where design of networks. Okay, network from here, what is it? Suppose network means in our home, we are all of houses in use, they will use Wi-Fi. So means Wi-Fi also, if you go distance wise, they will not connect easily. If you go nearby, then easily the net will come 24 hours without disconnecting. So this is the minimum spanning tree is used in the edges, means these are in the networks. Networks also, because of least cost paths. Okay, why we are using in this network means least cost paths we will use, right? The MSPT, minimum spanning tree, can be constructed using two ways, and one way is to connect the means to design the network means least cost path, and the second way is airlines also, means airlines routes, to find the routes also we will find, means airlines come compared to some other ways, airline lines. So in that they will use the routes, means to find the routes which we will use the spanning tree, right? So to most minimum spanning tree can be constructed by two ways. What are those? First one, Kruskal's algorithm, and next one is Prim's algorithm. Okay, Prim's algorithm. Kruskal's, what is the Kruskal's algorithm? Means Kruskal's uses the only edges we use. What is the edges means? These all the interconnectors or edges. Okay, these are vertices. Okay, only Kruskal's algorithm will use edges. Okay, and in Prim's algorithm will use what? Only vertices. So based on this, these two are important for minimum spanning tree, right? So these two are used for minimum spanning tree, right? So by using Kruskal's algorithm, we will develop the minimum spanning tree. Okay, this is the way we have to draw the first diagrammatical means map, and then we have to find the spanning tree and minimum spanning tree. What is the cost of minimum spanning tree? And then how to find the weight of less cost of the minimum spanning tree. So this is the way we have to find the very, this is a very very important topic in discrete mathematics. So because of nowadays airlines is very weak. So if you want to go in the short way, means within 1 hour, means from here to Bangalore, we can use this spanning tree, right? Because of, we will use the route finds, the routes in the airlines networks. So networks we will use in the lifetime, and airlines also we will use in the lifetime. These all are our lifetime. Generally we will use this because of generally, and means nowadays we will use this spanning tree. That's why we are, this is a very important topic in, so to find the minimum cost for spanning tree, right?